Intel just released their new 14th gen CPU lineup, starting with the i9-14900K, i7-14700K, and i5-14600K. If you have watched or read any reviews at all, you probably noticed that the performance uplift compared to the previous 13th gen Raptor Lake generation is almost non-existent. We're talking about maybe 3%, if there's any uplift at all. Some people call this a refresh generation, and some even claim it's basically the same CPU just with a new name. But what does all of this mean from a technical point of view? How small or big are the actual changes to the silicon itself? And is Intel really selling old chips with new names? Let's take a closer look at Intel's 14th gen CPUs to find out. A CPU can be improved in many different ways, some with a bigger and some with a smaller impact on measurable metrics like performance, power consumption, heat output, and so on. It's difficult to objectively say at what exact point changes to a CPU should be considered a new generation and when it's still the same old chip. To simplify things, I've picked four distinct areas which, in my opinion, cover the vast majority of how a CPU, or basically any chip, can be improved to a point where I would consider it a new chip or a new generation. The most obvious one is the underlying CPU architecture, which includes changes to cores, cache, and things like the memory controller. Of course, there is a range from a complete redesign, like when AMD went from Bulldozer to Zen, to smaller improvements like the increased L2 cache size of Raptor Cove. But if there's new silicon with architectural differences, however small, I'm inclined to call it a new generation. The second area is the process node. If a chip is produced in a new process node, even if there are no actual changes to the underlying architecture, it's usually called a die shrink. But since a improved process node can have big impacts on performance and power consumption, I would also classify a process node shrink as a new generation. Then we have the more straightforward core count and clock speed categories. Coffee Lake, for example, used the same CPU architecture as Kaby Lake and was produced in basically the same Intel 14nm plus process node. But it came with 50% more cores, 6 instead of 4. Even though it didn't introduce a new architecture or use a fundamentally new process node, it's clearly a new generation. The same could be said for a large increase in clock speed. A few percent here or there are not interesting, but a double-digit increase with similar performance gains can also push a CPU into new generation territory, although it's very difficult to increase clock speeds by a double-digit amount without touching the architecture or the process node. This is not an exhaustive list. There are certainly other areas like switching to a new socket, but these things usually go hand in hand with changes to one of the four areas we've just talked about. So what about Intel's new CPUs? Intel calls them 14th gen Raptor Lake refresh, which indicates it's the same but slightly newer or better. Raptor Lake itself wasn't a refresh of Alder Lake and did get a new name. Let's take a look at the differences. Intel released Alder Lake in October of 2021, almost exactly 2 years ago today, and Alder Lake was an entirely new generation. It introduced a new CPU core architecture. If we are precise, it even introduced two new CPU core architectures with its P and E core hybrid design, which also resulted in a huge increase in core count. Alder Lake was produced in Intel's latest 10nm enhanced superfin process node, which then got renamed to Intel 7. After years of being stuck at 14nm, a big jump for the process node. Only the clock speeds didn't really increase versus the previous generation, but that didn't negatively impact its performance. And Alder Lake also introduced a new socket and DDR5 memory support. The point is, Alder Lake hits 3 out of the 4 areas and was very clearly a new generation. Next is Raptor Lake, released a year later in November of 2022. It used the same Intel 7 process node as Alder Lake, and only slightly increased clock speeds, but it did introduce minor changes to the CPU core architecture with a larger L2 cache for the P cores, and it doubled the E cores to 16, which in turn also increased the L3 cache size from 30 to 36 megabytes. If we look at our four areas, Raptor Lake scores a few points for architecture and a lot of points for core count. Comparing the CPU dies of Alder Lake and Raptor Lake, the changes to the silicon are very obvious. Raptor Lake might be closely related to Alder Lake, but I still consider it to be a new generation, worthy of a new name and a new number. The single problem with the 13th gen was that Intel only updated the top die used for the 13900K, 13700K, and 13600K. Lower tier SKUs were based on older Alder Lake chips, something I've covered extensively on this channel. So what about Raptor Lake Refresh, Intel's new 14th generation? Well, see for yourself. On the left, we have a 13th gen Raptor Lake i9-3900K, and on the right, we have a 14th gen Raptor Lake Refresh 14900K. Can you spot the differences? I don't blame you if you can't, because there are none. These chips are literally the same. Yes, Intel is using the same CPU die with zero physical changes. Raptor Lake Refresh gets 0 points for architecture, since it's exactly the same as Raptor Lake, 0 points for process node, it's still Intel 7, 0 points for core count because it didn't add any cores, and maybe half a point for clock speeds, since it offers a 200 MHz higher boost clock compared to the 3900K. It's basically a 3900KS. Drop the basically, it's a 3900KS. Not only is Intel reusing the same CPU die, it's not even a new stepping which could have optimized the chip quality. Intel is taking the same Raptor Lake BO stepping it introduced last year, allowing them to run 200 MHz higher boost clocks out of the box, and then printing a new name onto the CPU. That's it. It's not a refresh, it's not basically the same, it's quite literally the same physical chip. If you would take the chip of a 3900K and a 14900K and compare them, there would be zero differences. You couldn't tell which is which. This brings us back to the initial question. When can a new generation actually be called a new generation? I'm very open to accept even small changes. Releasing a truly new generation every year is almost impossible, but consumers want new names and new numbers to continue buying. It makes sense for Intel to update their lineup on a yearly basis. I'd be even okay with a simple new stepping, something that shows Intel put at least a small amount of work into this new generation. But Raptor Lake Refresh doesn't even offer that. It's the same old chip from last year, only with a new name. And I don't even want to know what will happen to the low-end 14th gen CPUs, because I think it's very likely that Intel will again reuse the original Alder Lake chips, just renamed for a second time. Now, does that mean Intel's 14th gen CPUs are bad products? Yes and no. It's bad in the sense that uninformed consumers will most likely be tricked into thinking it's new by the updated numbers. But at the same time, Raptor Lake is still a powerful CPU. Just like the 13600K or 13900K, the 14600K and 14900K deliver a lot of gaming and multi-core performance for a decent price. And the 14700K even gets 4 additional E-cores on top. It's the same physical chip, but with 4 more cores enabled. The lineup itself isn't bad at all, especially since Intel did not increase the prices. If buying a 13600K wasn't a bad choice before, buying a 14600K with 200 MHz more for the same price isn't a bad choice now. Even more so for the 14700K with more cores for the same price. Both are great CPUs, and they most likely will be in the next years to come. My number one problem with Intel's 14th gen isn't the blatant renaming. It's the fact that it's most likely the last release on socket LGA 1700, since Arrow Lake, the next generation, is switching to a new LGA 1851 socket. If you are buying an Intel 14th gen CPU in 2023 or 2024, you are buying an old CPU with a new name on a dead platform, with no upgrade path, whereas AIM5 will at least support Zen 5 and Zen 5 X3D, if not Zen 6. This is especially disappointing since Intel is introducing huge changes to their mobile lineup with Meteor Lake, a true next-gen chip, which was also planned to release as a desktop version but sadly got cancelled. Compared to Meteor Lake, re-releasing Raptor Lake on desktop almost feels like a slap in the face. Let me know in the comments down below what you think about this move from Intel. Do you consider Intel's 14th gen to be a new generation? Or do you feel this move is a bit shady? I hope you found this video interesting, and see you in the next one.